Bonjour
everyone, Pentouf here today for a new video in which we're going to talk a little bit about the Black Friday, because it seems like Wargaming gave us some more things to talk about and some more things that are quite interesting, because as you can see, you have 4 times more experience for the first victory, so time for you to grind those tech tree tanks. You also have some bonus when converting elite XP to free experience. You also have some discounts on researchable vehicles, discounts on premium vehicles when you purchase them, 50% discount on instant vehicle upgrade. Never use that, even if it seems juicy. This is one of the greatest scams. No, you don't want to spend your gold just to instantly upgrade vehicle parts that you can get just by grinding. Do not do that, please. And discounts on enrichment, garage slot, etc., etc. Pretty much discounts on everything. So how does it work? Let me show you. The purpose of this video is to tell you which tanks or what you should do during those Black Friday offers if you have some spare gold or some spare credits that you don't really know what to do about. So we're going to start off that video talking about the premium, the tech tree premiums that are actually worth it since they have a huge discount. The first one, starting off with the American branch, is probably the T26C4. To me, this tank is a good alternative if you don't know if you should play medium or heavy tank, because this tank can do both. What I love about the T26C4 is that you have a medium gun mounted on a heavy tank. Of course, it has the heavy status, but don't be fooled. This tank is a heavy, and quite a good one, knowing that you have a lot of spaced armor everywhere, so it's definitely a good tank to buy if you are looking for some challenge at tier 8. And the cool thing about this tank is probably that even in the current meta, it's still a great tank. Now, of course, if we talk a little bit about the tech tree German tanks, the first one I need to talk about is the Jagdtiger 8.8. Since its huge buff it received in terms of DPM to the gun, it's one of the most competitive tier 8 tank destroyers and a really great one for the price with the 50% discount. 15% discount. So you better try to get it if you can. And out of all the premiums we're going to talk about today, if I had only one to tell you to buy, that would be the Jagdtiger 8.8. In its current state, it's an amazing tank. Of course, and another one that is a great one to have is the Lover. Not because the tank is overpowered, but honestly, it defends itself pretty well on the battlefield. At least in my opinion, this tank is a great one to get. And it also has one of the greatest credit coefficient in the whole game. So you better want to give it a try by buying it. And as long as you hide the lower part of your hull, you should be fine. Except, of course, if you are playing against tier 9 tank destroyers, that will probably smoke your upper part of the hull. Now, for the Russians, the SU-100Y, not because the tank is broken or anything like that, but just because of the gun. That's a cool meme tank if you just want to have fun wrecking people at tier 6, nearly one-shotting them when you use HE. So if you want to have some fun, you should get this tank, because as you can see, when you use gold shells, ooh, 530 alpha damage. And when you use HE, ooh, 600 alpha damage. For the rest, no, all the rest sucks in this branch, so we're not gonna bother. Here, same. I don't know. I don't know about the AT-15A. I would tell you it's not worth it because you have the equivalent at tier 8, which is way better, the AT-15, because in its current state, the tank became broken with that 4K DPM. So no, I don't think anything is worth it in terms of premium tanks in the tech tree. In the UK tech tree. I don't think Japanese has any, no, they don't have it. China neither. For the French, FCM not worth it, and you already all got it from the Twister Cup event, so we're not gonna bother. And finally, there is nothing in the Swedish or European tech tree as well. So you know what tanks to buy for the premiums. Now, you know what? I could talk a little bit about what tanks to enrich. I'm gonna talk about and focus on the main one. The first one is the Hellcat, not because the tank in its current state is broken, but because it's gonna receive a huge buff. in the 7.5 update. That is going to drop the reload time by 2 seconds. It's going to go from 8.5 seconds of reload to 6.5, which is going to give it a completely broken DPM. So you should try to enrich it if you want, simply over the fact that this tank is going to become broken in the 7.5 update. And don't worry, it's not just suppositions about the buff. Wargaming announced it. The Hellcat is going to have 2 seconds down in terms of reload time, which is going to make it one of the greatest tanks to acquire in the 7.5 update. Now, maybe another one to talk about is the T49. Not because the tank is actually a great one to enrich, simply because most of the time when you're using the T49, you're going to use a lot of gold shells. And when you use gold shells with this tank, as it's among the most expensive gold shells in the game, it's going to cost you quite a lot to play the T49 if you want to have fun with it. So if you play it really a lot, you should enrich it, because if you do, you are not going to lose credits anymore. You are not going to make a lot of credits either, but at least you will not lose all those credits you grinded hard to get. That's it for them. Let me see. Is there anything worth to enrich in the tech tree, in the German tech tree? I would say Tiger 1 and Tiger 2. Tiger 1 and Tiger 2 for the same exact reasons. They both have a great mobility, a great gun, and a great armor. But for the rest, I don't think it's worth it, because you have counterparts. For example, for the RHM, you have the Scorpion G. For the Yak Panther 2, I don't think you have for the Yak Panther 2. By memory, I don't think we have. But all the rest are not worth enriching. Now, if we talk about the Russians, I don't think you need to enrich anything. Maybe the ISU-152 if you just want to have fun from time to time, because that tank is really known among the community. But beside that, it's not worth it, because all the Russian tanks have a better counterpart version in premium. IS-6 and IS-3, aka Object-252U. T-44 has the T-54 Mod 1, etc. And the list is really long, so I'm not going to bother. For the British, I know it's going to sound weird to a lot of you, but the AT-15, trust me, it's freaking worth it to actually enrich it, because your shells are not costing that much, and thanks to its DPM and alpha damage gun, you are going to do more damage and therefore take more credits every time you shoot, which allows you to rentabilize even more your shells. So the AT-15 is a great tank for good players only, because you need to know how to angle with the AT-15 to make it effective on the battlefield. For the Japanese, maybe the Shito. Actually, the Shito is a great tank to enrich, in my opinion, because that tank is it's a really great tank. I mean, you are angled everywhere. As long as you try to hide your lower part of the hull, you should be fine. For the Chinese, I don't think anything is worth enriching, so let's give it a pass. For the Frenchies, as I told you in my top 5 best tanks per nation, ARL-44 is the go-to tank. I know a lot of people are going to tell me, no, but we have the Eraser, we don't need to enrich the ARL. Those are two different tanks, especially when it comes to the gun. That's why if I was you, I would go for the ARL, which is a better Eraser BP-44 overall. And finally, for the tech tree, the European, I would like to tell you the Emil 1, but based on the statistics Wargaming released about the performance of this tank on the battlefield, I'm expecting the Emil to be nerfed. So I'm not going to tell you to actually enrich the Emil, because it's 100% sure that this tank is going to get nerfed. So don't bother enriching it, except if you really want to have fun before the tank gets nerfed, but I don't think it's going to be the case. Finally, I think we talked about everything we had to talk in this video. So I'm going to leave you there. I hope this video will help some of you spending your money wisely. Of course, if you can, it's better to buy the tanks that are available in the Black Friday offers here, because with the coupons, it will allow you to get some kind of free premium tanks, such as the Type 62 and all those tanks. But if you are curious about a tech tree tank and you wanted to know which one to get, now you have your answer. Hope you enjoyed. If that's the case, feel free to subscribe, like, and share. I will not be able to stream tonight. I'm sorry, guys. And I have a huge surprise coming really soon for the channel, and I hope you will like it. See ya.